is, how can I ignore files in Git without using .gitignore? So if you put anything in a .gitignore file, either globally or in a local repository, Git won't track it. And you check this into your repository usually. You check this into your repository. But sometimes you want to ignore files just on your machine, just for yourself. So how do you do that without using gitignore? Okay, here.
Update index is too much action.
So, but you have to run that every time, or is that a flag? Okay, so let's. The one you are talking about is. How to protect them? Update index assume unchanged. So what does this do? That seems valid. Let me. Okay, so now I have a new file, and if I do that, you're saying it should be ignored.
You have to identify.
Okay. Yeah, so I have to add it to the index first, right? Yeah. What if it's a file that I just want to completely ignore, don't track at all? Yes?
I use keybook on the keypad.
So you will. So go to books and use the.
Is it on keypad?
I don't think there's a add book. The pre-commit book.
Pre-commit, yeah.
So what do you put in there?
At first you have a list of files, so you know, but it's not a git ignore, and then you go to the list.
Okay. Okay, yeah, that's a good one. Any other ideas? Yeah?
Why do you want to ignore files without using git ignore?
The motivation behind this was I was working with some devs who are using, I think, Windows, and my Mac creates all these extra files in my project, but I don't want to put it in a global gitignore. Yeah, just wanted to ignore some files that I was messing around with. So
I had a use case like that where I config file that is just my user credentials that I did not want to, but I didn't want to share with that also custom file name for everybody else.
Yeah. Yeah, the thing that annoys me a lot is I don't want to see untracked files in git status. Like, I don't like that red thing in there, so I just want to ignore it, but just for my local computer. So okay, so the way to do this is inside the git folder, in the .git directory, there's another directory called info, and there's a file in there called exclude. And this doesn't get tracked, but whatever you put inside this will get excluded by your project. So if you edit it and add file, and you can see my table is clean. Ta-da!
Wow.
Yeah, so a lot of things are hidden inside the .git folder. So if you're ever feeling bored or have 2 hours to spare, just look inside it and find some cool stuff. Yes?
What if you do git add and dot really together?
Now?
If
now I do a git add dot, no. No. So it's actually like a local gitignore. Basically, it's got a different name, yes?
Can you do wildcards?
Inside the file? Yes. In fact, in the samples, they're showing you the wildcards. So it's exactly like a gitignore, but you don't check it in. Alright, cool. So that is it for our exercises and talks. What time is it? It's 9. We have lots of stickers here, so please take some.
Yeah, there are plenty of stickers here as well.
Yes, we are allowed to
use. Was so nice to provide us with a lot to drink. So if you feel like you can take more cans, I'm not sure how long you can stick around, really. Like, they already left. But if you want a glass of wine, I'm not stopping here. And then tomorrow we do a big party, actually, the DevFest Belgium party. It's going to be at the National Design Center. There's a cafe in the back called Tapok, and they have a really nice outdoor space. The first 100 people that come get a free drink as well. So come.